Back for another 8-4, trying to take down one of these drafts. Have not had the best of luck thus far. Kind of interesting. Victory Tail is pretty clearly our pick, but it's not so high above other cards I'd be unwilling to take another card. Just happens to be that this pack is not that strong. Like, the two best cards are probably Blue Sandraker and Treasure Hunt, or Treasure Mage, and then Pierce Strider and Goblin War Driver are both fine. Pierce Strider is obviously way better than Goblin War Driver. Crush is another fine card. And the Shriekorn deck I've seen in triple MBS, but not in Besieged Scars. So here we're pretty much going to take the best card, which just happens to be True Conviction on with Wings, and see how that goes. We got past a Mortar Pod, so we're going to be taking it because the card is bananas. There's Lumigrid Gargoyle here, which is fine. Quicksilver Geyser actually thinks fine. I actually like Ichor Wellspring a lot too. But in the Glintalk deck, I think Mortar Pod is just as good because you get to keep bouncing it and reusing it like Contagion Clasp style. So Mortar Pod is definitely super strong, and can't complain about those first two picks. The dreaded Blightsteel Colossus, obviously. I don't care how much it's worth. We're not going to take it here. Mainly because there's a Serum Raker in the pack and a Piston Sledge, both of which have uses. I think Serum Raker is the blind better card. In certain decks, I would take a Piston Sledge over Serum Raker, but I think just, you know, pick three, you know, no real direction yet, I think Serum Raker is just stronger. Blightsteel Colossus is kind of fun to play with, but definitely not a good card by any means in Limited. This pack's pretty dead. There's a Master's Call and a Blister Stick Shaman. I think Blister Stick Shaman is very powerful, but I don't think it's powerful. I shouldn't say very powerful. I think it's very playable and it's very good, but I don't think it's that much better than something like Master's Call that we should abandon our kind of game plan right now. Granted, we don't have a strong game plan, but I don't really want to move into a different game plan for just a Blister Stick Shaman. If that was a Burn the Impure or something, I'd be more willing to, but Master's Call is pretty strong at common, good with Mortar Pod, good with Victory's Herald, and I think overall it's just going to be a better card for us. You know, we could end up not white, and Blister Stick could have been the right pick, but I think that where we're at right now, I think Master's Call just offers a little bit more. Like I said, Burn the Impure or obviously like a Flame Fiend or something like that, we'd quickly snatch it up. Blister Stick Shaman, though, it's not the most fun card to splash just because its effect later on is not that good. And you really have to be blue to be playing, or be red to be playing it. I mean, like I said, it's a fine card. I wouldn't fault anybody for taking it there. Maybe red's open, but then again, all these red cards are kind of like meh. Goblin War Driver, Crush. I'm actually a fan of Sphere of the Suns. I know other people are not, but I like it a lot just because I tend to splash cards more than other people, and it's the kind of card that lets you do that. Keeps Metalcraft going. Find other strategies. And I mean, Crush and Goblin War Driver just not strong enough to move into red. They're worse than Blister Stick Shaman was. So if I wasn't going to move out for Blister Stick Shaman, I'm sure it's not moving out for either of those. But I like Sphere of the Suns. It's one of the mirror you could pick up in this pack effectively. And, you know, just being able to keep your colors open is pretty strong. Alright. Next pack has the Steel Sabotage, which I like a lot. I think it's a very, very good card. Rusted Slasher, which is another solid card. Quicksilver Geyser is fine. Razorfield Rhino is fine. This basically comes down to Steel Sabotage versus Rusted Slasher, and I think both those cards are good enough that I'd be willing to take either one. I think Steel Sabotage is a little bit better, though. Rusted Slasher is fine, but you can usually pick up that type of effect elsewhere, where Steel Sabotage, I think, is the premier counterspell slash bounce spell in the format. Especially, we already have a Mortar Pod that goes well with it, and you don't even need to have anything that goes well with it, obviously. It's just fine on its own. But, in some respects, it's Glinthawk. In other respects, it's, you know, Counterspell, which is fine. So far, we're setting up pretty well for a Glinthawk-type deck, which is what Ichor Wellspring goes best in. Peace Strider is fine, but I think I want to try this deck. I haven't played it yet. And, you know, white hasn't been coming per se, but these types of effects have. And it goes fine with Steel Sabotage as well. Peace Strider is a good card, and I think I would take it the majority of the time here. But people keep telling me that this deck is super awesome, and I'm going to give it a shot. There's another Steel Sabotage for us. I don't think the deck generally is paired with blue, but at the same time, I don't think blue is out of the question. And I think you're basically trying to draft a white deck with some splashed removal or whatever else in the deck. So You know, White hasn't been coming, like I said. It's I don't even know if it hasn't been coming. It's just White is not super strong in the first pack. There's like Leon and Skyhunters and whatnot, but Victory's Herald and Master's Call are both okay, and you know, you don't even have to end up with a lot of white cards. So, you know, Ichor Wellspring is solid enough that it'll make most decks anyway. I think Peace Strider, like I said, is overall a better card. But we're going to give this a shot, experiment a little bit. You can't experiment on Modo for real-life tournaments, then I don't know where you're doing your experimenting, but this seems like the perfect avenue to do so. All right, Crush tabled and Kaldotha Flame Fiend tabled. I think we're just going to take a Blade Descent here, though. Not awesome, but acceptable, so we're going to take it. Shriekhorn is another option there, but it's not very good. Virulent Wound should probably not be in the pack. Nathasaur as well. We're just going to take Banishment Decree. I can see sideboarding that in or running one of it in the main deck if I have to. It's pretty good against the Fatties decks or whatever. Again, not super ecstatic about it, but no reason to move into another color just yet. Red is clearly underdrafted right now. I don't know about it being open, but it's definitely underdrafted. With Blister Stick Shaman coming late, Nathasaur coming late, Crushes tabling, it's stuff like that. But I don't think it's so underdrafted that we necessarily need to move into it, but it's something to keep track of. We will go ahead and take a Concussive Bolt here, because why not? But you really don't want to switch, especially out of a color where you got a 6-mana bomb. You really don't want to switch out of one of those colors because a Nathasaur came or whatever. You'd rather it be Horde Smelter, like a draw the colors, which I'm perfectly willing to do. Completely depends on, you know, how the rest of the packs go, and we're not going to be 100% stubborn. We only have 3 creatures right now. We do have Master's Call, so it's like 4 creatures, I guess. But Plague Maw Beast and Cost Courier are both very strong in the respective duties. This guy's out of the sideboard. This guy's out of Infect or whatever. We're just going to take this because I don't want to have to face it. I've lost to that card before. It's also very good with Ichor Wellspring style cards. Not Ichor Wellspring itself, obviously, because it's not a creature. But that's like Perilous Mirror, Oculus, things like that. Take a Shriekhorn. Barrage Ogre is the card good with Ichor Wellspring. Spire Serpent's a fine 13th pick or 14th pick or whatever. Even got a plane so that we can splash this Master's Call. With the aliens coming down from the sky. That's what it looks like to me. Alright, back-to-back 6-mana white bombs, and you end up white. That's how things work out. Might not be the Glintalk deck, but we're going to be a control deck. We have 2 Steel Sabotage and Victory's Herald and Sunblast Angel and all this good stuff, so definitely not complaining. Peace Strider might end up being better in a deck than the Ichor Wellspring because of that, because we just buys us time and gives us some life and whatnot. But good old Sunblasty. No one open Sunblast Angel complains when they can play it. And got our Angel Duo here. This one's a male, I'm pretty sure, though. No, it's kind of got... I don't know. Every time I assess art, I end up coming up short. All I'm saying is, who drew Sunblast Angel? Jason Chan, I'm a bigger fan of you than RK Post's Angel. I like RK Post in general, but not in this particular situation. This is kind of interesting. No real white cards to mention. The only blue card worth mentioning is Riddlesmith. There's a Stoic Rebuttal, I guess. But there is, like, Turn to Slag and Spikeshot Elder. Both those cards are pretty strong. I could see not playing blue. I mean, I don't feel bad if we don't take Riddlesmith here. It's ultimately what I'm trying to say, I guess. We do have a Sphere of the Suns already. I think I'm going to take a Turn to Slag here. We might not be able to play it, but I'm not too upset about passing Riddlesmith, and, you know, the chance that we get to splash Turn to Slag is strong. Obviously, we're going to take a rest here over Turn to Slag because it's on color, but I don't feel bad about passing Riddlesmith. It's not my favorite card, and removal's removal. Like I said, if we don't get to play it, so be it, but picked up an arrest here, which is nice. Here we pick up a Perilous Mirror, another solid pickup. Twisted Image, not that exciting. Nothing else really even worth mentioning. I could lie and say it is, but especially we have Mortarpod, Perilous Mirror gets that much better. This pack's also not very good. Although, Trigon Amending, I think, is pretty good in this style of deck, where we're just trying to buy time. That said, is it better than Oriok Edgerite? I'm going to say yes. Obviously, I could draft a better card, of course, but Trigon of Mending has its uses, and this is the type of deck where I think uses kind of come out. So, we currently are showing 17 playables. Obviously, not playing all of this. I'm going to hide this Concussive Bolt, as a matter of fact. Since if we're splashing, it's not going to be for that style card. But Dispersed, Flight Spell Bomb, Mere Galvanizer, Thrumming Bird. Does Thrumming Bird do anything for us? Sphere of the Suns and Trigon, that's really it. Does Galvanizer do anything for us? We have Perilous Mirror. Flight Spell Bomb does not look super exciting either, though. I think I'd rather just take Galvanizer as the chump blocker kind of guy, and then if we pick up more Mirror, he's going to be that good. And Flight Spell Bomb is just super replaceable in this style deck. We're not very aggressive, so it's not going to be that strong there. I'd rather just have the Grey Ogre. As bad as Grey Ogres are, sometimes you just need them. Especially when we only have six creatures and we're playing a Victory's Herald. Here's a Galma's Warden, which I think will be fine in our deck, and a Soliton. I think Soliton's the pick here. It only costs one more mana and it has more combo applications. Galma's Warden's fine, but we currently only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 artifacts we're playing. So I think Soliton's going to be overall better. If we pick up a Heavy Arbalest, it'll be pretty strong as well. You know, Galma's Warden, if it costs like 3 or something, we would take it there, but I don't think the difference between 4 and 5 is strong enough to take a card that's basically minus 1 to the power and has no real combo applications. Good old blue-white control. Victory's Herald is totally fine on its own, by the way. I was saying that, like, we want creatures for it, and that's true, but, you know, no one's ever complained when they've attacked with a 4-4 flying lifelink before. Another pack kind of devoid of everything. There's a quarter shield, which we may or may not play, and nothing else we'd even consider. Untamed Might being the card we would hate the most, but we'll just take a quarter shield in case we need it. Maybe we pick up a Tringamage or something, we want it. Stoic Rebuttal versus Halt Order. We already have two Steel Sabotage that have a Stoic Rebuttal. Or it gets right again. It's okay, I just don't think it's going to be that good in our deck. When there's another Stoic Rebuttal. So now we're just really looking for defensors and removal, and I think our deck will be pretty solid. Any walls or mirror or anything like that would be greatly appreciated. Pack 3, I'm talking to you. There's a Bonds, a Leonin Arbiter, and a Scrap Diver Serpent. A bunch of cards that we're fine taking. I think Bonds is the most likely to make our deck just for a lack of removal. Scrap Diver Serpent's pretty replaceable. We already have a couple of big finishers, so I'm not too worried about passing up on it. I'd like to have one Bonds for the sideboard at least, so. Glimmer Post, it is. Scrap Diver Serpent would not be, you know, bad in this deck, but we do have a Spire Serpent, and we have, you know, these two 6-drop guys, and we have an entire pack to go to pick up something like him. So, you know, would be fine in our deck, I don't think missing out on him is bad there. When I would definitely like a Bonds, at least for the sideboard. You know, we could even play it in our main deck right now. It depends on if we get some red mirror or not. We don't have to splash turn a slag, it's just an option, but like I said, I'm not too upset about not having a Riddlesmith. I would have played the Riddlesmith, to be fair. But we didn't even know we were in blue at the time, full-heartedly. There's an Iron Mirror. There's also a Wall of Tangle Cord and a Kemba Skyguard. Three cards that we kind of want. I feel like we do need some Mirror in this deck, though. And there is a Lux Cannon. What can we do with Lux Cannon? Do we have any combos? No. No proliferate of any kind. We could have taken some Throwing Birds and whatnot, but I don't think. I guess we have a lot of counter spells. It is kind of just slow removal. Might be good in our deck if we just start taking defensive stuff. Maybe I just take this and have some fun with it. I mean, I definitely want Iron Mirror and Wall of Tangle Cord, but I kind of want to play this card in my deck, so we'll try it out. Here's a Revoke Existence. A little bit better than Necropede and Wall of Tangle Cord in this case, just because we don't have a lot of this effect. We're pretty much just looking for those defensive creatures. Ooh, Mirrorsmith and a Heavy Arbalest. I would generally say Heavy Obelisk would be good. We only have one Soliton, though, and Mirrorsmith kind of does what we want to do. It's early, provides other early blockers, good with Mortar Pot, etc. So I think we're definitely going to take that. We're really just trying to shape our deck to be good in the late game with this various cards like Lux Ganon and Victory's Herald and Sunblast Angel. Here we get an Origin Spell Bomb, which is perfectly acceptable. It's another another mirror for our Galvanizer. Another artifact for our Mirrorsmith. Right now we're not playing Bonds. And next card to be cut would be Banishment Decree. Be cool to get a Sky School or something like that this pack. So I can cut Banishment Decree for it. A couple Steel Sabotage I think are nice. We do have Sphere of the Suns as our kind of mirror replacement. Ichor Wellspring not doing a ton in this deck, but that's fine. It's providing Metalcraft, I guess, and drawing a card. Trigon Mending would go after Banishment Decree. What we have here? We have nothing. Guess we'll take this card to fight Infect. I think it's better than Loxon and Wayfarer against fighting Infect. Only 9 creatures, but we do have Master's Call, Origin Spell Bomb, and I guess that's it. 2 hidden creatures currently. Oh, a Mortar Pod. 3. I don't know if you really count that or not. This deck is interesting. Not a ton of removal, but we're blue-white, so you can't expect too much. We have Evoke Existence, Arrest, Sunblast Angel, Lux Cannon. Like I said, I definitely would like a mirror or some walls or whatever. Maybe we'll table some of those cards. But I think trying out Lux Cannon is going to be pretty sweet. There's a Glinthawk and a Scott Yule's cool. Which else do we want more? We have Mortar Pod, Ichor Wellspring, and I guess that's really it to combo with Glinthawk. We have Sky of School being Sky of School to combo with itself. I guess we have Mirrorsmith to combo with Glinthawk too. It's only -1/-1 from the Sky of School. See, I think we take Glinthawk. Banishment Decree is gone. Not really sure on that pick. I think I haven't drafted this deck ever, so I don't really know what the pick orders are. I don't know if anyone's ever drafted the blue-white version, but we'll see. Alright, now we get our choice of Darksteel Sentinel or Kemba's Skyguard. Sorry, for my roommate's phone. I think both of these have some merit in our deck. Again, we have some 6 drops. I guess we just want the Darksteel Sentinel as kind of removal and something to do with our counter mana open. We already have like Master's Call to go with it. So I think it's going to be a little bit better than Kemba Skyguard. We also might table a Kemba Skyguard from earlier, which would be pretty sweet. Ooh, and a Glinthawk Idol. Probably better than Lumigoodrake. Let's see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, Glinthawk Eye is going to be better than Lumigoodrake, for sure. Another thing from Mirrorsmith. We did table that Kemba Skyguard. So our deck's coming up pretty strong. We're going to cut this Trigon of Mending. It's 25 cards. What else are we cutting? Our deck's pretty strong. Another Trigon, Golden Urn, Turn Aside. I think we'll just take another Trigon for the sideboard. Don't really need Turn Aside. Soul Fairy would be good against Infect. Trying to think of what we're cutting out of this deck. I just honestly don't know. I mean, we could cut Sphere of the Suns. There's Disperse. But I think Sphere of the Suns is pretty good. Could cut Bladed Sentinel. I'll take a... Spire Serpent's an option. Age Sentinel, Spire Serpent, I think, are the two number one cards to cut. Master's Call is another one. I don't know if Master's Call does enough in our deck. Those guys are in. I think we want at least one of these. This guy will sit over here. Probably playing it, though. This guy will also sit over here. Not a lot of blue cards. We're pretty much a white deck. But I'm fine with that. This guy's going over here as well. In Soliton versus Spire Serpent. That'll be interesting. We didn't table our Heavy Arbalest, so... Sphere. Alright, there's 20, so we get three of these cards over here. 2 5-drops, 2 3-drops, and a 4-drop. Of those, I'm going to say Blade of Sentinel's definitely in. We need that type of curve. Then we have our 5-drops and our 3-drops. I like having access to Stoker Butt on this deck, but I also like Master's Call. I guess Master's Call doesn't really do a ton for us. If we're not playing the Serpent... Because at that point, I guess we have Mere Galvanizer and a Mortar Pod. Those are two selling points. I'm not sure if it's worth it. I think I want to play Soliton over Spire Serpent because of Mere Smith and the fact that I don't know if Spire Serpent will ever be able to attack. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, yeah, Spire Serpent's not going to make the deck. As far as which one of these are making the deck, I'm not sure. I kind of like having a second Stoker Butt on this deck. But Master's Call also has its advantages where, like, they're playing around Counter Magic and you put a couple guys into play. Or whatever. I'm going to start the Stoker Butt. Think overall it'll be better. The blockers are nice and everything, but hopefully, you know, we'll board it in for sure against like poison. We'll take out these Stoker Buttles, but hopefully this works out. Let's add some mana to this beast. 9/8. I'm fine favoring white. We got double white and triple white and double white. Do have some double blue, but that's fine. Alright. We only have 11 creatures, but again, Origin Spellbomb, Glinthawk Idol, Mortar Pod, and guess that's it. So we have 3 hidden creatures. But I think that's fine. Sphere of the Sun should be pretty good in this deck, too, getting us to our 6 drops faster. I wish it was a mirror, to be fair, but oh well. Alright, we're going to sleeve this up and see how it goes.